okay, this section is going to be on defense against a blade or anything that cuts. You know, number one, in reality, I don't think people really understand the importance of a blade. Okay, could be a knife, could be a sword, could be a busted video, it could be a busted DVD, anything that cuts, a bottle, anything that cuts. But the seriousness in this, number one thing you want to do is run. But if you can't run, you're in bad, bad condition. Okay, it's very, very serious. The odds are you're going to get cut, you're going to get hurt. So what I want to do is I want to give you a good idea of how to train different scenarios with the knife, how to look at it. Like I said, of course, always run. What we're going to do is look at today what they call the sewing machine action. A guy's coming to you, got a hold of you, and trying to stab. Okay? Let's give this a shot. What we're going to discuss here is what they call the sewing machine action. Now, I want you to understand the number one thing to do if somebody pulls a blade, run. You know, or anything that cuts, a busted DVD, a busted bottle, anything that cuts, because the odds are you are going to get cut, okay? So what we're about is we want to survive. We want to survive this. So I've seen people where they've showed this, a guy's got this, what they call the sewing machine axe, he's got a hold of me, and he's stabbing at me, this is where they grab, and they try to get control here, and try to control this arm, and do things like this here. This is not going to happen. This is about strength. And then you got to always remember, this guy's got a hand, two legs, a head, other things that can happen, okay? What you want to do, now I'm not saying when you do this, okay, man, I'm gonna walk away, okay. This is about survival, this is about living, okay? So the number one thing you have to train is pain. Pain changes the game. Pain interrupts, okay? So let's say he's giving me this sewing machine action like this here. What I want to do is I want to drop and hit. This hand's coming down, trying to get in the way. Notice my body mechanics. I'm zoned away from the blade and I'm hitting. So I'm hitting like this here. Okay? I can also do it like this. As it's coming, this is a hit. I'm trying to get rid of this blade. This is a hit. This is a hit. At the same time, and I'm zoning out of the way of the blade. Another one is doing the same thing. I could drop, he's giving me that action, I could drop with this hand, okay? But I'm always hitting, notice, I'm always hitting, it becomes one. It's like, he's giving me that action, boom, you stab like it's so good, push me back up. It's one, this is one movement, see? And then I can go into all these things, see, here. Okay, smiles, boom, whatsoever. Okay, all right? So the number one thing is you want to cause pain, interrupt. So he's giving me that action very slowly. He's giving me it. This drops. This is a one movement, not a one, two. This is one, okay? I can see, go again. I can do all kinds of stuff. Bam, see? I can do all styles. Kind of stuff, all right? All right, so one more time. Nice and slow, he's giving me the action. This one drops, I hit, I'm zoning out of the way of it, okay? He's giving me that forward pressure, it's going that way. He's giving me the action again, for whatever reason, I drop, I'm zoning, and it's going that way, but I'm hitting. It becomes one movement, so this is one, I'm hitting, not one, two. We do not fight in a 1-2 or 1-2-3 beat. We fight in a rhythm. Get rid of the 1-2 or 1-2-3 beat. It's no good.